I have a 6-year-old boy, a son, and I see that he's capable of, you know, so much more than I imagine a 6-year-old is capable of. Especially in today's world, parents are busy, you know. We are so much more busy than our parents used to be. Extracurricular activity in their minds is always either music or sports.
We appreciate you being an early adopter of STEAM. Could you tell us how challenging was it to introduce a STEAM to a school and convince the parents and as well as other stakeholders in the school?
So the main challenge in our school is usually the financial aspect, because parents don't usually want to pay anything extra in addition to the school fees. And a extracurricular activity in their minds is always either music or sports. So introducing robotics was something very different, but we knew that, you know, once they see that their children are actually enjoying it, that they would be convinced about it. And since many parents are from the IT field, we knew that they would see value in this program and that they would encourage this, their students and the school, to go forward with this program.
Okay, thank you. Ma'am, things are changing and evolving, and it is a change is always a nice thing to have, as long as it is a progressive and post impact. So recently at Cutie Pie Robotics, we had a 9-year-old boy who persuaded with his parents to do an intern with us, and that was very motivating and encouraging for us. So having said this, I would like to understand from you, how do you see your children start interning at companies at a very young age, and what age do you think is appropriate for a child to start an internship in a company?
I think that's great to hear about this 9-year-old boy. To me, age is just a number, you know. I have a 6-year-old boy, a son, and I see that he's capable of, you know, so much more than I imagine a 6-year-old is capable of. So I don't think there is, you know, an actual start date or end date. If a child is capable, if a child is willing, if the child is comfortable about doing it, I think he or she should be encouraged to start an internship at any age. I think the main problem would be parents. I myself, as a parent, I can't imagine sending away my 6-year-old child to, you know, to intern. Mm-hmm. But in general, I think if a parent is also convinced about something, mm-hmm. and I think it's about comfort. It's about comfort and the safety of the child. Right. And so we as a school would definitely encourage our children, if they are capable and if they are willing, it'll be a wonderful opportunity for them.
So maybe some amount of an awareness or a talk and discussion with the parents in general, yeah, about internships like this and available for child, would it help?
It really will. I think awareness is very, very important, especially in today's world. Parents are busy, you know. We are so much more busy than our parents used to be. And so just, you know, maybe, you know, sharing articles with them or having workshops with them, you know, just to make them aware. And to know that, you know, these are the opportunities, and maybe also what these opportunities could lead to for their children.
Wonderful. Thank you. I'm sure some of the parents who are listening to you will start thinking of something on those lines and will be encouraged by, at least from the Axe Group of Schools, we will look forward to have children with us interning in future. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Some schools have where they set up a robotics lab and where they have a material from third party, and they have their own teacher who run this lab. So how do you see this as an option, ma'am?
I don't think it would be a very feasible option, in my opinion, because, you know, teachers in school, they have a different kind of mindset. So sadly, the mentality of the teachers is such that they always want to complete portions, they're working towards an exam, or, you know, just sticking to the curriculum. So I don't think that having a robotics lab with our own teacher would work. I mean, you guys have a passion and you are trained to do what you do, and you're not fixed by a certain curriculum or an examination that you're working towards.
Right.
So I think that would be a better option.
Okay, but is there any way where we also can motivate teachers and try to look into one more perspective of and trying to help child to learn more than academics? or include even academics as well in the part of learning?
Yeah, I mean, I think ideally it would be great to integrate robotics into the subject matter,
right,
you know, so that it becomes part of everything, and I think it would make the lesson more interesting as well.
Right.
And I'm sure there would be teachers who have this hidden talent or this interest, you know, to work with STEAM. So I think that would work as well.
Okay, ma'am, I would like to understand, like, a lot of teachers who teaches in schools and across India, we don't see a lot of articles coming out of them as a blogs or writing for the newspapers or writing for the magazines. Why do you think that ecosystem still lacks in terms of teachers doing those for the children in the school? Because I feel if teachers are vocal, I am sure the children will become more vocal about it, and
correct,
it's going to create and mostly a positive ecosystem for the future.
So I think teachers in India are still under the impression that they're just teachers, they're nothing more than teachers. And it's only if you're a professor or working in a university or a college is when you start writing articles or attending conferences. But since you mentioned that, we have a colleague of mine has been encouraging our teachers to, you know, publish at least 3 journals a year,
wow,
attend conferences, and, you know, the importance of upgrading yourself and doing things like that. So we are encouraging our teachers. And I'm sure there will be some budding writers. And right now, they don't think, you know, in that direction.
Yeah.
They're just, like I said, they think they're just a teacher. They come, teach, do their job, and then they go home. So we're encouraging them to do more than just that.
I'm sure it will change and evolve.
I hope so, yes.
Student expectations are growing, and
yes,
teachers will be asked to perform more larger than what they're doing at
the Yes, moment. That's right.
I have a final question to you to understand. I would like to see what would be your message for people who are thinking of STEAM as a part of the education system, and some of them still are not aware of, like, how to integrate STEAM within into the schools and into the curriculum.
I would say that our future is so diverse. There's just no one path that every child or even adult is going to go on. There are going to be so many different paths. And I think that it's great to explore the various opportunities that come your way, whether it be STEAM or whether it be environmental work or art. I think it's important to dabble and in everything that comes your way, so that will help you, you know, make a better decision for the future.
Wonderful. I'm sure our listeners and viewers will be very excited to listen to your views, and we're very happy to receive comments further from them. And thank you for your time. It was nice talking to you.
Thank you.
And thank you for your various inputs on the same.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.